Hi, this is Heel Cross Stick Tech editor John Weaver. When you fully extend on a shot, you need to pull down pretty hard on the shaft end to get that leverage working for you. So what are you pulling down on to get that power? End caps can be inconsistent, and when they slip, sometimes even wrist injuries occur. Most players just tape the end cap on, and a lot of college kids use what we call the college tape job. And we've added the butthead finish to fully customize the most important part of your shaft. Take your athletic tape and start about a quarter inch tear. Begin wrapping the tape around the very end of the stick until you have about a quarter to a half inch of depth. We're going to add about another quarter inch of depth, so you be the judge. If you're not going to do the last step and rubberize the tape end, then you want to leave a little bit of tape over the edge of the shaft. Okay, the first step is done. So take your tape again and start a 1/8 inch tear and start wrapping that around the upper half of the tape that you already laid down. After adding about a quarter inch or so, tear the tape, smooth out the tape. You can smash it or roll it or squeeze it, pulling on it and hitting on it against stuff, but basically make sure that it's tight and compressed. If you're not going to do the rubberizing part, then be sure that the tape extends a little bit over that metal edge of the stick. To create the butthead college tape job version, grab a can of Grip Dip or Plasti Dip. These are sold in your local hardware store to repair hammer handles. Be sure to do this outside and lay down some protective work surface like a sheet of newspaper. Open the can, do not shake it first. Do not breathe the stuff in while you stir a couple of times with the stirrer. Okay. Walk away and take a few breaths. This stuff stinks, and it stinks for a reason. It's not very good for you, so make sure you're not breathing it in. Okay, hold the stick over the can and dip at least 1 inch past the tape. Pull it out and roll the excess off over the can. There will be visible spots missing and defects because of the air bubbles, but the butthead will be lighter, faster, and perform perfectly with these visual flaws. But dip twice for more coverage if you want to. This is going to make it a little longer in the drying process, and it's going to make it a little heavier. It will not make it any better. One dip is fine. Lay it down over the paper, but don't let it touch anything. Close the can, walk away, and take some deep breaths. Let it sit for about 15 minutes or so, and then turn it so that the rubber doesn't lean as it dries. If some excess has dripped, don't worry, it happens all the time. Let it dry outside for about 5 days if you did the double dip, or until it doesn't smell at all anymore. We mean it. If you're lucky, it might be 3 days if you dipped only once. You're almost done. The next step is easy and will be done shortly. Take your can of all-surface clear acrylic spray and shake it up good. Take some painter's tape or masking tape and tape off the actual end, leaving just about a half inch to an inch at the top exposed. Spray it pretty well, rotating the shaft. Let it dry for 15 minutes, then give it a second coat. Let it dry again for 15 minutes, and you are ready to go. Give it a try. Let us know what you think.